Republic Organization of Ukrainian Cossacks existed on the territory of Ukraine for more than 200 years. It was called the Zaporizhian Siege. It covered the present-day Kirovograd, Dnipropetrovsk, part of Mykolaiv, Kherson, Zaporizhia and Donetsk oblasts. The Zaporizhian Siege was a democracy, as it was based on the principles of Cossack democracy and universal equity. It had the right to elect its own government, had its own administrative division, own court and maintained diplomatic relations with other countries. Unlike other feudal states, the key principle here was paid labor, not enslavement of workers. Besides, the Zaporizhian Siege played an important role in the national liberation struggle of the Ukrainian people, shaping of a national elite, and development and settlement of the vast territory of steppe Ukraine. Scholars consider this formation to be the only democracy in the world of the late 18th century. It was the first attempt that can be considered in the context of European history. A new era had already begun. The English Revolution had won. Despite a short victory, its achievements have been still used because the British model of democracy remains an example for the whole world. Practically the same occurred in our country. Ukraine did not develop in isolation from other European countries. A simple analogy could be also made between Europe and the US, but the latter was not involved in the revolution. Scenarios of the events in the pre-revolution U.S. and Ukraine's pre-Dniprivia coincided. It was an unprecedented event. The Zaporizhian Siege had great potential for establishing an independent state in Ukraine.
Українське козацтво мало те, щоб відродити, мало продовжити традицію.
Ukrainian Cossacks were tasked not only to revive, but to continue traditions founded in Rus. Traditions continued to exist even in the times of the Grand Duchy of Lithuania and the Russian Empire. During the Lithuanian-Polish period, they had to rise it to a new qualitative level and become the basis for establishing a national state.
Саме національної держави, саме українське козацтво.
It was the Ukrainian Cossacks who realized their attempt to establish a national state. The above attempt was initiated under Bogdan Khmelnytsky. This was a revolt which evolved into the first Ukrainian nation revolution of 1648-1676, which led to establishing an independent national state.
Мала бути самостійна національна уже держава.
Ukraine certainly had a chance to become an independent state. However, as soon as the 1768-1774 Russian-Turkish War ended, the external threat disappeared in the south of Russian Empire. Although the Zaporizhian Cossacks helped Russia win the war, later there was no need for them. On April 23, 1775, Russian Empress Catherine II ordered to destroy the Zaporizhian Siege. According to scholars, this anti-Ukrainian measure was influenced by social, economic, and political motives. Tsarist Russia was discontent with the siege as the center of Ukrainian peasant revolts and anti-feudal protests. Besides, the Zaporizhian lands were turned into a powerful agricultural region with small farming economies.
На момент скасування Запорізька Січ землі війська Запорозького.
When the Zaporizhian Siege was destroyed, its lands were an economically advanced American-based model of the development of agriculture.
Адже чому вона манила втікачів селян?
Why did it attract serfs? Because it was effective, a management practical of a free person on free land.
Ефективного господарювання вільної людини на вільній землі.
And the last commander of Cossack camp, Petro Kalnyshevsky, actively attracted all SKPs to show the effectiveness of an agricultural capitalist-based market economy.
Ефективність оцього передового фермерського капіталістичного ринкового господарювання.
On June 4, 1775, Russian troops returning from the Turkish front surrounded the Zaporizhian siege and seized its lands without any resistance as the Cossacks' main forces were at war. As a result, Cossack leader and wealthy Cossacks were arrested and their property was seized. The vast territory of Zaporizhian lands became a part of the Russian Empire and later were distributed among Russian nobility. After this, the Zaporizhian siege ceased to exist.
Цей крок Катерини II був цілком мотивований як крок імператриці російської держави.
Catherine II did as a great Russian empress would do.
Знищення Запорізької Січі.
11 years before destroying the Zaporizhian siege, the Empress sent instructions to Prosecutor-General of the Russian Empire Alexander Vyazemsky, in which she explained that existence of the so-called autonomies of Finland, Livland, and present-day Karelia and Little Russia within the Russian Empire that were governed with confirmed privileges was counter to the state's policy.
І Малоросії, які управляються конфірмованими, наданими їм правами, не співпадає із лінією державної політики.
In order to reduce hostility from the inhabitants of Finland, Livland, and Little Russia, it was necessary to align their state systems with those of the empire. It had to be ensured, those times were marked by the abolition of the hetman's post, that the name and glory of hetmans disappeared.
І потрібно зробити так, щоб і саме того року ж було ліквідовано то посаду гетьмана в тисячі.
This would lead to unification of rules and regulations all over the Russian Empire, so separatist movements and dynastic hetmanate projects would no longer be a threat to the empire hegemony.
Правила поведінки, і вже не треба буде боятися сепаратистських рухів, будь-яких проєктів там гетьманства родового і так далі, тому подібне.
Kazakh's leaders, who avoided the Tsar's repressions and acquired the status of nobility, silently accepted the destruction of the Zaporizhian siege. The only person who publicly expressed his disapproval of such changes was a descendant of a Kazakh family, former officer and writer of the famous Ode to Slavery, Vasil Kapnist. In 1791, he went to Prussia to meet the Prussian king. Among other issues discussed was active support of the idea of rebuilding an independent state in the territory of Ukraine in the case of war between Prussia and Russia.
Василь Капніст, да, він якраз типовий був представник української козацької старшини, який чи не востаннє, мабуть.
Vasil Kapnitz was a typical Ukrainian Cossack leader. Probably it was not the last time when he tried to involve interventionism policy to free Cossack Ukraine by exploding powerful European states.
Потужних європейських держав. Відвідав королівство Пруссію, яке тоді саме.
For this person, he visited the kingdom of Prussia that began recovering and gained momentum with the start of the Napoleonic Wars.
І запропонував.
He offered the head of the Prussian government support in the case of attacking Pridnipровia. He was carefully listened to in Berlin, but nobody took action.
Якщо пруська армія, приміром, з'явиться у Дніпрянщині. Його уважно вислухали у Берліні, але до.
Because combating the expert of revolution from France was high on the agenda. That was whom it was necessary to fight.
На порядку денному стояла боротьба проти експорту революції революційної Франції.
Besides, the Russian Empire was an influential member of the coalition of European powers against France.
Базових учасників тих антифранцузьких коаліцій.
The Persian king saw the future of this empire in close ties with Russia. In fact, Kapnist returned home empty-handed. The last hope of foreign support in liberating Ukraine was dashed, but patriots demonstrated a great wish to fight in order to rebuild the Ukrainian state. After destroying the Zaporizhian siege, part of the Cossacks could escape across the Danube, where they created the Dunajska siege in the territory of Turkey. It existed more than 50 years. Composer Gulag Artemovsky eloquently told about the life of Ukrainian Cossacks abroad in his famous song Zaporizhian Beyond the Danube. In 1828, when the next Russian-Turkish war began, Ukrainian Cossacks refused to participate in it on behalf of the Ottoman Empire. The Dunajski commander of the Cossack camp, Josip Hladki, transferred his army to the Russian Empire. Subsequently, they settled on the coast of the Sea of Azov between the cities of Mariupol and Berdansk. The Azov Cossack host was founded here and existed until 1860. The Zaporizhians who remained across the Danube were accused of treason. The Turkish government destroyed the siege and the Dunaj Cossacks settled throughout the Ottoman Empire. According to historian Mikhailo Hrushevsky, after the Zaporizhian siege was destroyed, 8,000 Ukrainian Cossacks moved to Zakarpattia. Austrian King Joseph II, who owned Zakarpattian lands, permitted them to establish the siege there.
А ті, хто переселилися на Закарпаття, то і далі вони переселилися.
Those who moved to Закарпаття advanced further inland to the province of Voivodina within the Austro-Hungarian Empire. They were engaged in guarding the southeastern borders of the Habsburg dynasty.
І сама назва.
The name of the ethnos, Rusinians, remained the same as it was the Middle Ages.
За часів середньовіччя русини. Русини.
The ethnos of Ruthenians still live in both the Republic of Croatia and Vojvodina in the Republic of Serbia. Ruthenians were distant descendants of those who settled under the Habsburgs after the destruction of the Zaporizhian siege.
Що знайшли собі прихисток під скіпетром Габсбургів після руйнування Запорізької січі.
Most Ukrainian Cossacks, after destruction of the siege, stayed in the Russian Empire. Cossacks united in the Black Sea Cossack host, which participated in the 1787-1791 Turkish-Russian War. The host was given Getman regalia confiscated during the destruction of the siege. Cossack titles, as well as the administrative divisions since the times of the Zaporizhian siege, were restored. After the war ended, Cossacks hoped to return to their ancestral lands. However, the Tsar government opposed it. On May 21, 1791, the government secretly ordered to resettle the Black Sea Cossack host to Kuban. Settling here, the Cossacks were engaged in animal husbandry and farming. They participated in the hostilities in the Caucasus in the Crimean War of 1853-1856. Over a century, the Black Sea Cossacks followed the traditions of Zaporizhian Cossacks and preserved their ancestral heritage. In February of 1918, as an allegiance to the Ukrainian People's Republic, the Cuban People's Republic was declared in Yekaterinodar, present-day Krasnodar. A few days later, the resolution for a federal union of Cuban with Ukraine was adopted, but Denikin's volunteer army interfered in these plans. Having seized Kuban in early 1919, Denikin's troops launched pogroms against Ukrainians. They arrested Legislative Council members, removed the blue and yellow flag from building of Ukraine's embassy, and arrested Ukrainian ambassador Fyodor Borizhansky. Kuban became the core of forming the White Movement against Bolshevism, but when in summer of 1919 Denikin decided to fight against Ukraine, the Cuban Cossacks refused to go to war against their co-brothers.
Під час громадянської війни якраз у Антона Івановича Денікіна вам
during the civil war it was commander of the armed forces of South Russia Anton Denikin that had serious doubts about the Cuban Cossacks as they had preserved their ancestral heritage
кубанської армії, а тому що вони зберегли історичну пам'ять.
This is precisely the reason what when he started the war against the Ukrainian People's Republic and decided to use the Cuban Cossacks against the army of the UPR, his plans failed outright.
Використовувати кубанську армію проти армії Української Народної Республіки за великим рахунком нічого з цього не вийшло.
Moreover, a large number of Cuban Cossacks were part of the combat units of the UPR army. They actively took part in hostilities against Bolshevik and White forces. One such unit was the formation of Cuban Cossacks headed by Cossack leader Yushkevich. His troops first entered Kyiv in May 1920. Since the establishment of the Bolshevik regime in Cuba, supporters of independence who opposed the Soviets were subjected to violent repressions. During the Great Famine of 1932-1933, also known as Holodomor, the historical memory of Ukrainian Cossacks' descendants was eradicated.
Мабуть, таки до великого голоду 1932.
Apparently, Cuban inhabitants remembered the Ukrainian ancestry right up to the 1932-1933 Holodomor.
Що кубанці вони однієї крові із українськими козаками.
But the Great Famine and repressions forced them to change their Ukrainian citizenship to Russian. It's clear that the state power gradually erased the collective memory of the Cuban Cossacks about their true roots.
Спогади були якось вилучені державною владою.
Having destroyed the Zaporizhian siege, the Tsarist power put an end to Cossack democracy. It ruthlessly enslaved peasants and forced Ukrainians to seek shelter under other monarchies or in other regions of the Russian Empire. Ukrainian historians consider Zaporizhian Cossacks to be the first refugees who were unable to learn their mother tongue abroad and became the victims of the forced assimilation policy. Afterwards, they completely lost connections with their historical homeland.